What would you do if you lost your job and no one would hire you? Welcome back to my channel. If you are just thinking about this problem, when you get put in this situation, it's likely too late. Or in the best case, you're digging yourself out of a deep hole that's a lot harder to dig yourself out of if you would have just prepped for this in advance. So think about this now. Be proactive, not reactive. So hopefully you have some extra income you can put to work while working this W-2 job. And I'll explain why that is very important later. So let's start building passive income sources. Hopefully you never have to run into that worst case scenario when you don't have work and you can't find work. But if you do, having multiple sources of income will help you get through these hard times. And the average millionaire has 7 sources of passive income. How many sources do you have? If you only have a couple or even 0, we're going to run through some different ways you can start building these up. So what can you do with the extra money that you have now? And if you don't have extra money, where can you find extra money? Well, I guarantee you are all spending money on something you don't need. Do you have unused subscriptions or subscriptions that you barely ever use? Maybe cut those out. Excessive amounts of vacations? Well, maybe you can cut back one a year. Luxury clothes, nice new cars. There's a difference between a reliable vehicle and a vehicle that you just don't need. These are just some of the ways that you can start cutting back on the things you don't need so you have extra money to invest. What I'm about to cover isn't fancy. It's not any get rich quick scheme that you're going to become rich overnight. It is going to require sacrifice, some delayed gratification, but think about it. Many of the people that are truly wealthy, you wouldn't even know are wealthy. The people that look rich, most of those people are buried in debt. So let's not be those people and get yourself set up financially. So we're going to kick that off with a way to do that with very little extra money. So if you want to stay in the traditional banking space and have that FDIC insurance protection, you can open up a prize pool or YADA account, which is Prize Link Savings. Now, this isn't going to be a steady source of passive income. As for prize pool, it goes completely off of a lottery system. So the more money you have in there, the more tickets you will get every week and chances to win prizes. They give out $50,000 of prizes every single month and the grand prize of $25,000 every single month. And YADA gives you a 0.2% guaranteed APY on your money, as well as the chance to win prizes, with the grand prize being $10 million. Now, there's no guaranteed prizes that YADA gives out every month like prize pool, but these are just two small ways to start saving and making a little bit of passive income. You also have some high yield savings accounts, even though there's not really a such thing as high yield savings accounts with interest rates being so low right now, but those accounts that will get you anywhere between 0.25 and 0.6% are accounts like SoFi, Ally, Betterment, and Wealthfront, just to name a few. Now let's go into my favorite way to really start earning some passive income, even when you have just a little bit to start investing, or even holding your funds outside of the traditional finance system. And this would be doing things like unbanking yourself, putting money into these crypto lending platforms like Celsius, earning you 10.51% APY on USD coin, Voyager brokerage earning you 8.5% on a $100 or more monthly average on USD coin, and Outlet Finance with a 6% APY on your funds. Also, Celsius and Voyager, you can earn interest on your cryptocurrency if you have cryptocurrency holdings. So check those out. I already have in-depth reviews of all of these on my channel. And sticking into the cryptocurrency market, with some cryptocurrency assets you hold, you can stake them or add to liquidity pools in order to gain interest as well. So let's go back into traditional finance and go over another way to start building passive income. You can buy certain stocks and ETFs, pay dividends of all different amounts depending on what you hold. Now, this isn't a way you're going to get rich with a couple $100s, but having good habits in place gives you the ability to do this later on when you do have more money to work with. Also, interest on bonds, which isn't my favorite, as I see this being one of the bottom passive income choices, but that decision is on you and your risk tolerance and what you want to put your money into. And let's get into what I would say is the best way to really start earning passive income, and that is real estate. In multiple different ways, you can earn passive income through real estate. Let's start out with the least money down way. You can get an FHA loan and only put 3.5% down on a single family house and house hack, meaning you live there and rent your rooms out to a couple buddies. Or with that FHA loan, you can also buy a duplex, triplex, or quadplex. Anything 1 to 4 units qualifies for residential mortgage, and anything 5 units and above, you will need a commercial loan. So with an FHA loan at 3.5% down, and you get yourself into a duplex to quadplex, you can live in one unit and rent out the other 3. Now, remember, when doing this, if all of your funds are in that 3.5% to put down, that is not a good idea. You need a reserve. because now you are not only responsible for the unit you live in. If something goes wrong or breaks in those other three units, you have to fix that and you need the funds to do so. So be responsible if you look into this method as a passive income source. You can avoid private mortgage insurance, PMI, by going with a traditional mortgage, usually having to put 25% or more down on a duplex, triplex, or quad, but your rate will be lower. This is all on what you have saved. And if you are in a better financial position, you could start buying rental properties. I house hack as well as have multiple rentals, which is great long-term passive income. Somebody is living in the house you own and paying it off for you. And if you do it right, you're making money every month as well. That sounds like a pretty good deal to me. Now, this does require a lot of research and making sure you're getting yourself into a good deal. This is just meant to put that little spark underneath you and start thinking about ways to protect yourself and also set yourself up for retirement. I don't think any of us really want to be working when we're 70. So, as I said right at the beginning of my video, that W-2 job you hold showing that steady income is going to help you tremendously in real estate getting started. It's pretty hard to get a loan when you're jobless or are self-employed. So by having that W-2 income, this will help you get started with rental properties, as they do want to see proof of personal funds in order to give you that loan so that they feel that investment in you will be paid back to them. Also, think about things like if you own your personal residence or have a decent amount of equity in that right now, you could take a HELOC, home equity line of credit, against your property to buy your first investment property. That is how I bought my first two investment properties. Now, this should only be short-term lending, as you probably are paying a higher interest rate. So if you're getting into a project that you need to do some work on, fix it up, put renters in it, and refinance that into a traditional mortgage, getting you a lower interest rate. This is called BRRRR, buy, rehab, rent, refinance, repeat. So after you refinance, you can pay off your old loan and do it again. And none of these are truly passive income sources. Some of them you have to put upfront work to get started and it turns into more passive income. And some are fairly passive from the start. But let's jump into the next one, online businesses. Now, I've done a few small things through being a rep of different companies, and it never really panned out to be a big difference monthly for me. But this is all on what you're selling, if you're a rep, or if you're buying bulk product to sell on, say, Amazon or another site. I'm not a professional on this topic, so you're going to have to research this if this is something that you want to get into. But can you monetize a hobby or skill that you have in order to make a secondary income? This could be a great idea for you as well. And if you were getting anything out of this video, it'd be great if you hit that like button, subscribed, the little bell right at the bottom in that corner, you can hit that right now and subscribe. Go ahead and hit it. And also hit that bell notification so you get notified every time I make videos in the future. So to be fully transparent, especially if you don't have a lot of money to start, none of these things are going to make you rich right now. Having good habits in place and just seeing that money slowly build gets you in the position so when you do have more funds, you will be better off. Just think of things like if you buy that $7 Starbucks cup of coffee every morning, stop doing that. Make your coffee at home and invest that money elsewhere. Even if that is putting that $3 to $7 every single day into some kind of savings account, whether that be in traditional or cryptocurrency space, earning you interest or at least giving you a shot at prizes. It's so easy for us to spend money on coffee, to spend $15, $20 here on dinner, to go on that quick little couple hundred dollar vacation. But people are scared to put $100 or $200 in, say, a stock or a cryptocurrency because it might go down. Well, guess what? It might go down, but it also might go up, especially if you are in good companies and projects. It's just a mindset thing, and you have to change your mindset to be comfortable with this. So at the beginning, you might only be making pennies or dollars every single week, but with these habits in place, those pennies or dollars will grow into hundreds of dollars, and if not thousands of dollars every single week, or more, depending on what avenue of passive income you are looking into. So start building those passive income sources and give yourself a raise. I'll see you next time.